it's just posts that join and log in on Facebook. Good morning, everyone. Welcome. Okay. Should I just start with my Facebook friends?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So, welcome, Facebook. Happy Saturday. Great to have you all here. Wanted to take a second today to introduce myself. My name is Megan Cannon. I teach yoga here at Merit. If you are taking this class and would like to post on social media, either on Facebook or Instagram, just a little plug, tag Merit Clubs, so that's at Merit with two R's and two T's Clubs. And also my Instagram handle is Canon Yoga, so that's at Canon Yoga, CannonYoga. And today we're gonna get started in Child's Pose. So getting right into it, rolling over onto your knees, allowing your hips to press back towards your heels, and arms extend long. So option for your knees, knees can come together or knees can come out as wide as your mat here in this Child's Pose, allowing your chest to fall between your thighs. Good, so resting in our Child's Pose here for a few moments. Beginning to come into your breath. So feeling that breath as you lengthen with every inhalation and every exhale out. Then breathing just a little bit deeper. Coming into our theme for today's practice. All is okay in this moment. And this moment. And this moment. Affirm your life in every minute. Be mindful of the past and open to the future. But when the past feels undermining or the future overwhelming, choose to be fully in the present. When we spend too much time agonizing about past mistakes, we lose track of what is happening right before us. When we are overly anxious about what is to come, we lose the joy of living our daily lives. Try this. Ask yourself, is this particular moment okay? Then affirm, yes, this moment is okay. And now, this moment is also okay. And now this one. When you feel yourself losing your connection to the moment, ask yourself, is this particular moment okay? Ask yourself this question and then answer it again and again. Good, so taking a few more full breaths here in your Child's Pose, walking your fingers more towards the front of the room. Keep reaching your hips back towards your heels. Good, nice long spine, allowing your forehead to be supported by the earth here. Good, and then sending your breath into any spaces of tension. Easing up, softening, letting go. Good, using your breath to relax your muscles and become fully present here in this moment on your mat. Good, and then on our next breath, spreading fingers even wider here, beginning to curl your toes underneath of you. Good, and then working to straighten your legs, moving into our first downward facing dog of the day, pedaling out your feet here right away. Good, getting into your body. Maybe with every inhale, sending the right heel down, and on every exhale breath, the left heel pedals down towards the ground. Good, for three more breaths here with movement, maybe shifting hips from side to side, rolling onto the outer edges of the feet, moving into your spine. Good, last breath here, relaxing through the upper back and shoulders, feeling a slight round in your spine. Good. Belly button drawing up towards your spine. Next breath, exhale, hips lift. Downward facing dog for three breaths here. Good for two. For one, inhale, shifting forwards, coming into high plank, and everyone slowly making your way all the way down onto your belly. Good, coming into a nice easy quad stretch, bringing your left hand underneath your chin or your face. Good, and then bending that right knee, grabbing for that ankle or the top of the foot. Here we go, quad stretch with that right. Good, so as you pull the right heel towards that right glute, begin to press both hips down into the mat. As we relax where we can relax and let go, feeling that stretch moving through the right quad muscle. Engaging through that glute, drawing the heel closer to the hip, pressing both hip bones into the mat. Yes, feel that stretch deepening. For two more breaths. For one, releasing that right foot, right hand comes underneath the chin or the forehead, bending the left knee, grabbing for that foot. Working to grab for the top of the foot or the ankle, drawing the heel closer towards that left glute muscle. There we go, stretching through the left quad here. Length through that right leg, pressing hip bones down into the mat. Letting go of any tension in your neck or jaw, maybe in your shoulders, allowing the stretch to be just in that left leg. For one more breath. Beautiful, releasing that left leg down, coming towards our cobra pose. So everyone bringing hands underneath the shoulders, drawing the elbows towards the back of the room, reaching them back, shoulders beginning to lift up the mat, up off the mat. Spine nice and long, neck remains long here. As you inhale, begin to press up. So we're pressing through the hands, engaging through the back, glutes begin to engage, tops of the feet pressing down into the mat. One more breath. Exhale, lowering down, pausing for a moment, keeping your hands right where they are. Chin or ear can come to rest on the mat. Then rising back up one more time, chin and forehead comes back for center. Inhale, begin to lift. This time for more of a challenge, keep pressing the tops of your feet into the mat, engaging through the backside of your body. Palms can lift up an inch off the mat. Good, one more breath, rising. And exhale, slowly lower down, opposite ear to the mat. Arms can release down by the side. Good, one more breath, resting in stillness. Then hands come back underneath the shoulders, rising up onto all fours. Moving into our cat-cow pose right away here. Similar action as our cobra pose. Inhale, open through the collarbone, through the chest. Exhale, rounding the spine. Chin comes towards chest. Inhale, opening. Good. Exhale, rounding cat pose. Taking three more here at your own pace. Good. Moving with your breath. Coming back to that question, is this particular moment okay? Yes. It is, right here in the right now. And once you've taken your cycles, coming back into a neutral spine, working into our core here. So straightening out through that right leg, left arm reaches forwards, bicep by the ear, thumb pointing up towards the sky, pinky down towards the ground. Next breath, straightening that right leg, lifting it, good. So knee and ankle come hip height, holding strong here for one more breath. Then exhale, lowering down. Right knee regrounds, left leg begins to straighten, right arm. Good, thumb pointing up, pinky pointing down. Lifting that left leg, straightening out. Knee and ankle at hip height, beautiful. Good work, holding strong here for one more breath. For two, inhale, grow long. For one, reaching out, this time bending through the right knee, reaching back towards that right ankle. Can you grab it? If so, opening up through the chest. So that's why we've done some heart openers. That quad stretch, can you open wider? Good, twisting towards the left side of the room, maybe just a little bit. And without slingshotting, control, releasing it, extending long, and lowering down. Good, switching right to the next side. Left leg straightens, right arm lifts. Next breath, crunching in on the exhale for four, lengthening long. For three, beautiful, for two, lengthening out, one more, crunching in, extending long, left knee bends. Keeping that foot flexed as you reach back, opening up. Yes, opening through the chest, kicking into that right hand. For two more breaths. For one, with control, releasing, extending long, and lowering right hand, left knee down, sitting back in child's pose. For three full breaths here. For two, allowing yourself to rest. And on one, spreading fingers wide once again. Curling toes under, sending the hips high into our downward facing dog. Holding for three more full cycles of breath. Reaching the heels down towards the mat. Reaching the sits bones high. Yes, one more breath. And again, gazing forward between your hands. Walk, or this time maybe step your feet up between your hands. Feet come hips width distance. Inhaling, half lift. Exhale, folding. Inhale, rise, flat back, all the way to standing, reaching up. And exhale, hands draw together at heart center. Good. From here, we'll move a little bit further. Moving into our flow, I want to center myself here. So keeping hips, feet hips width distance, bringing hands to heart center. This time we'll inhale, reach up. Good, exhale, coming right back through center. This time noticing as you reach up, do your ribs jut forward. So inhale, reach up. Good, draw those ribs back in. Exhale, come back through center. This time, arms come down by the side, coming into a back bend. Inhale, arms reach up. Mini back bend as they reach slightly back. Exhale, hands come to heart center. One more time, mini back bend. Inhale, arms reach up, opening. And exhale, folding over the legs. Good. Inhaling, half lift. Exhale, hands plant, step it back, high plank. We'll take this flow three times. So on this first one, optional. feel the outer arms wrapping in as you find length along your back. Using the strength of the front of your legs, engage those quads, feel the length through the backs of your legs. Sending heels down towards the mat. One more breath. Beautiful. Gazing forwards between your hands. This time, if you'd like, walk, step, or float up between your hands. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, folding. Good. Inhale, rising all the way to standing. Palms come together. And exhale, hands draw down to heart center. Heel toeing your feet mats with distance. Bending down so we can. Toes pointing outward slightly, knees track over the toes, coming into our yogi squat. Option to bring a block underneath of you if you have access, maybe stacking a few pillows, bringing support, drawing the hands together at heart center, pressing the elbows out into the thighs to open up. Yes, sit a little bit taller, reaching up through the crown of your head, just one more breath. And exhale, folding, hands plant, legs straighten. Two breaths here, allowing yourself to fold deeper. For one. Then heel toeing your feet in, hips width distance. So hips width, maybe about 2 fists in between. Inhale, half lift from here. Exhale, fold. Hips begin to reach back, knees bend. Moving into our chair pose, arms lift, beautiful, biceps by the ears, sinking the hips back and down as you reach your fingertips towards the front of the room. For two more breaths, opening up through your chest, tucking the tailbone, bending deeper into the knees for one. Exhale, folding forwards, deep forward fold here. I'll do this, I did it last week. Coming forward a little bit so you can see my feet. Parangustasana, yogi toe grip, peace fingers grabbing the big toes. Wrap the thumb around those 2 fingers. There we go. Inhale, find length with this grip. Exhale, fold deeper, drawing the elbows out wide as you fold. There you go. And as we fold, feel that traction. So we want connection between belly and thigh, so as much bend in the knees as is needed. Then once you have that connection, working to straighten the legs. So feeling that action of pressing feet down, lifting sits bones up towards the sky. Your legs might not straighten, but we want to keep that connection between belly and thigh. One more full breath. Yes, exhale, releasing the hands down towards the ground, folding, one more breath. And then inhale, half lift, rise. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rising all the way back up to standing, palms come together to touch, and exhale, hands come back through center. Moving into our shoulders, so standing at the top of your mat, feet again, hips width distance. Inhale, breath, reaching both arms high. Exhale as you lower that left arm down, bending the right elbow, reaching between your shoulder blades. Then bending that left elbow, reaching up towards your shoulder blades. So feeling an internal rotation of that left arm as you bend the elbow and reach up. Feel the action of reaching if you have a strap or a belt, maybe using that. Or if you can, hooking, finding a bind here. So grabbing opposite hands, opening through the shoulders. Once you're set, reground through your feet, standing a little bit taller, begin to press the base of your skull back into that right forearm. Reaching that right elbow up. Feel that stretch moving into your right tricep. Feel the opening in your chest. The expansion through your shoulders for one more breath. Then as you release, not slingshotting with control, releasing both arms come down by the side. Pausing for a moment here. Everyone shrugging the shoulders up by the ears. Exhale. exhale, releasing them back and down. Yes, two more like that, shrugging the shoulders up. Exhale, release them back and down. Last one, shrugging shoulders. Exhale, release back and down. As you inhale, arms reach up. Right arm lowers down by the side. Left elbow begins to bend, reaching between the shoulder blades. Internal rotation of that right arm reaching up. Good, right arm reaching towards shoulder blades as well. Using that strapper belt, grabbing hold if that's where you went on the first side. Finding balance, taking the same variation. Grabbing for our opposite hands. Re-grounding in your feet, setting yourself up to hold here. Pressing the base of the skull into that left forearm this time. Reaching that left elbow up, feeling that stretch. Moving with your breath, again asking yourself, is this particular moment okay? If there's a bit of struggle, you're losing your breath, is that okay? Yes. Last breath here. Releasing the arms down with control, coming down by the side. Again, three shoulder shrugs, shrugging the shoulders up. Exhale, release back and down. Taking your time. If you're moving a little bit slower than what I'm cueing, that is okay. Last time, shrugging shoulders. Exhale, releasing them back and down. Good. Stepping back to the top of your mat. Hands coming onto hips. This time, bringing your feet together. So toes come together, heels come about an inch apart. Moving back into our chair pose, this time challenging ourselves a little bit more by shortening our stance. So challenging our balance slightly with hands on hips to begin, bending the knees, reaching the hips back and down. Good, next breath, arms can extend forwards and up. Beginning to draw the hands together at heart center. Next exhale, twisting over to the right. So chair pose twist. In our twists, with every inhale breath, finding more length of the spine. With every exhale, twisting deeper. So press that right hand down into the left, working your heart more towards your thumbs as you twist. For one more breath, pressing through the right foot, keep your torso right where it is, stepping back to a twisted high lunge. Root down through that right foot, step the left foot back, landing in high lunge, readjusting, coming back into that twist if you lost it, coming back to your breath. As you twist deeper, holding for one more breath. Option to stay here, or if you'd like, splitting your arms, maybe working towards a bind, moving wherever you're going today. For two more breaths, if you're bound, working your chest even more towards the sky, whichever variation you're doing, that's where you're going. One more breath. Exhale, unwind, hands frame the foot, step that right foot forward, forward fold. This time just coming into ragdoll, grabbing for opposite elbows, allowing your head to hang, ears coming between the biceps. Same thing, bending your knees as much as you need to. Maybe this time shifting from side to side, bringing a bit of a rocking motion into your ragdoll. And next breath, hands come down towards the ground, slowly rolling up, stacking one vertebrae at a time, chin taps, head comes up last. Beautiful, stepping again to the top of your mat. I'm coming to this side so I can still talk to you. Toes come together to touch, heels about an inch apart, hands on hips. Moving to our left side, knees begin to bend, hips reach back and down. Working to get our knees to track over our ankles. Working, I said, might not be there. So hips reaching back and down, arms reach up. Next breath, hands come to heart center. As you exhale, twist over to the left side. Yes, similar cues. Pressing that left hand down into right. As you exhale, twist deeper, reaching hard towards the thumbs. Gaze can come up towards the sky. If it's comfortable for your neck, move that twist. One more breath here. Grounding into that left foot, reaching back, sending energy back through that right heel. Option to move further if you're splitting your arms. If you're moving towards a bind, grabbing for opposite hands and opening up, twisting deeper for two more full breaths. For one, unwinding hands, frame the foot, step that right foot forward, ragdoll, grabbing elbows, crossing your arms the opposite way. If you remember how you gripped, grabbing the opposite way and allowing yourself to fold, bringing balance into our practice by crossing arms the opposite way there. If you'd like, rocking from side to side just a little bit, bringing that balance back in. Breathing here for two more breaths. For one. Great work, everyone. Releasing your hands down. Slowly rolling up, stacking one vertebrae at a time. Head rising last. Before making our way back into a sequence, once again, let's shrug our shoulders up by our ears. Really just find opening and space as you release them down your back. Two more times, shrugging shoulders up. Exhale, releasing back and down. Last time. Exhale, let it all go and just shake it out a little bit. Good, we'll need that. Coming back to our right side, stepping to the front of your mat if you're not already there. Coming back into our chair pose, feet come together, arms begin to reach, hips reach back. Right away, hands come to heart center. Exhale, twisting over to the right side. Yes, finding that twist, holding strong. Sending that left foot back, ground through that right foot, step back, high lunge, twisting. One more breath here. Beautiful, and then I'm gonna come to this side. We're in our twisted high lunge. We're opening out to our left side, bending into our left knee, half squat, and reaching forwards to our warrior two on our right side. We'll offer an opportunity to try that again. But in our warrior two, landing here, checking in with our feet, right heel in line with left inner arch, deep bend in that right knee, 90 degree bend, working knee out towards pinky toes. Extending the arms forwards, right arm reaches forwards, left arm reaches back. Even energy out through both sets of fingertips. One more breath here, bending even deeper still. Flipping the right palm, revolve, reach back. Good, exhale, windmill forwards to side angle. Right forearm onto thigh, left arm reaches towards the sky, or moving it to reach overhead. Options for our bind. Right arm can reach down, moving further. Left arm can begin to bend, reaching towards that right glute or right hip. Half bind. For full bind, snaking that right arm underneath the left, grabbing for opposite hands. Opening up, option to stay here, or if you'd like, moving towards your bird of paradise, gazing down, step that left foot forwards, inhale, rise up to standing. Good, working to straighten that right leg. I'm gonna come back, hold inside angle with whomever's here. Birds holding for one more breath. Begin to lower that left foot down, or that right foot down. Step the left foot back, everyone meeting back in side angle, forearm onto the thigh. Inhale, rising through center, straightening through that right leg. Should be a lot of release here. Moving into triangle, bumping hips towards the back of the room, reaching that right arm forwards. When you can't reach anymore, right arm reaches down, left arm rises. Gaze can follow towards that left thumb. Beautiful, gazing upwards, rooting strong into both feet. Feeling that opening, shoulders stacking over one another. And next breath, inhale, reaching up through that left hand, rising. Right palm flips, revolves. reaching back through those right fingertips. Two more breaths here. For one. Inhale, rising back through center, turning all 10 toes to face the side where you're already facing. Hands coming to heart center, so wide-legged forward fold. Toes come inward slightly, heels come out, slightly pigeon-toed. Protecting our knees here. Inward, inhale, heart begins to open. Exhale as you hinge at the hips, folding. Hands coming beneath your face. As you fold deeper, think chaturanga arms, so elbows bending towards the back of the room. As much bend in the knees as is necessary. Working to walk the heels of the palms in line with the heels of the feet as you fold forwards. So we're going to be here for a little bit. If in your practice you have a headstand and want to move there, your head connects with the earth, you want to bring knees onto triceps, or lift straight from this position, lifting your feet as you rise to your headstand. That's not where you're working today. Working deep into your fold. Staying here. Shifting away more forwards into the balls of your feet. Reaching the crown of your head down towards the ground. And if you're floating in your headstand, slow and controlled, making your way back down, reconnecting feet with the earth. Everyone walking hands back underneath your face, flat back. Inhale, long spine. Beautiful. Exhale, hands roll onto hips. Inhale, rising all the way to standing. Right toes turn to face the front. Bending into that right knee, warrior two. Inhale, flip the right palm, revolve, reach back. Exhale, windmill, handspring the foot, step that left foot forwards, forward fold. This time grabbing for opposite elbows behind your legs. So allowing yourself to fold just a little bit deeper, hugging your belly onto your thighs. One more breath in your fold. Releasing your hands down by the ground and inhale, rising all the way up. Resetting, making our way to move to the second side. Hands come up to hips. Stepping the feet in and together. Chair pose. Arms reach up. Hands draw together. Sink those hips a little bit deeper. Exhale, twisting to the left. Setting yourself right up, balancing into that left foot. Step the right foot back. Twisted high lunge. Twisting deeper. Heart opening up. Beautiful. Second side. Beginning to open to the right side. Coming here so you can see. We're reaching back, bending into that right knee. Half squat on the right side and opening left side, warrior two. Yes, setting up. Left heel lines up with right inner arch. Deep bend in that left knee. Working towards that 90 degree bend. Hips, shoulders, ribs all stacked in one plane. Arms reaching out. Relax the shoulders down away from the ears. Beautiful. Gazing over that left middle finger. One more breath here, bending even deeper still. Core nice and tight. Flip that left palm, revolve, reach back. Good, then moving forwards toward our side angle. Left forearm onto thigh, right arm towards the sky. Or reaching it overhead. And if you're moving further, left hand can come down towards a half or full bind. Right elbow can bend, reaching back. Left arm can snake underneath that left thigh, grabbing for opposite hands, opening up. Option to move further, still challenging our balance, gazing down to where that right foot's going for your bird of paradise. Step that right foot forwards. Rising up, one strong breath to standing, balancing on that right leg, working to straighten through that left leg, holding in your bird. Good, one more breath if you're flying. torso lifts, beginning to straighten through that left leg. Release. Sigh it out. Beautiful. Coming into triangle, hips bump back. Left arm reaches forwards and down. Right arm reaches towards the sky. Gaze can follow towards that right thumb. For two more breaths, left hand can be on the shin or a block, whatever is comfortable and accessible. Last breath here, inhale, rising, reaching through that right hand. Left palm revolves or flips over to revolve to our triangle pose. Feeling that stretch from your left toes all the way along the left side body out through your fingertips. Beautiful. Relaxing that shoulder again away from your ear. One more full breath here. Torso lifts back through center. This time coming into our goddess squat. So toes turning outward slightly, like in our yogi squat. Our knees are tracking out towards our toes. Knees will be stacked over our ankles. Inhale, arms lift into goal post. So elbows in line with shoulders, wrists stacked over elbows. Next breath, tuck the tailbone, engage the core as you begin to squat down. Good, imagine you're sitting, doing a wall sit almost, with wide legs. So press your back up against that wall. Yes, ribs and shoulders stacking over the hips. Can you sink a little bit deeper? I know you can, no one's watching. I can't even see any of you, but I'm sure there's hundreds of you. Sit a little bit deeper. Two more breaths for one. Yes, inhale, release, straightening through the legs. Let it go, coming into one more goddess squat. Inhale, arms reach, goalpost arms. Exhale, bending the knees. This time, lift the right heel off the mat, rising into toes. Good, grounded, sink a little bit deeper, left heel lifts. Reground, sink a little bit deeper, my glutes are burning. Lift both heels, shaking, it's okay. One more breath, both heels ground, inhale, reach all the way up, beautiful, yes. Good, let's go. Left toes turn to face the front of the room, bending into our warrior two, both arms reach out. Inhale, put that left palm revolve, reach back. Exhale, windmill hands frame the foot. Stepping that right foot forward, again, folding. Both hands wrapping around the legs, grabbing props and elbows, folding deeper. For three more breaths. For two. Reaching sits bones high for one. Releasing hands down by the sides. Inhale, rolling up, stacking one vertebrae at a time. At the top, last time here, just once. Inhale, shrug shoulders. Exhale, release them back and down, making our way back to our mat. Inhale, arms reach, mini back bend. Exhale, full diving forwards. Inhaling, half lift. Exhale, hands plant, step it back, high plank. Option if you'd like, three push-ups. I'm not gonna do it, but you sure should. Lowering for three. For two, you got this. For one. Everyone exhale, hips lift, downward facing dog. For three full breaths. For two, spreading those fingers wide, noticing the difference in this down dog than the last we were here. For one, really great, so I'm going to switch. Inhale, reach that right leg up. Exhale, stepping it forwards, rising up, warrior two. Good, holding for one more full breath. Inhale, flip that right palm, revolve, reach back. Exhale, moving forward, side angle, just a breath. Forearm grounds, left arm reaches overhead. Good, coming back through center again, lunging back, bend into that left. one. Hands come to frame the foot, curl the left toes under, straightening the leg, stepping it back, high plank, and everyone hips lift downward facing dog. Moving to the left side. One more breath, and then coming to our left side. Left leg reaches up. Exhale, stepping it forwards, rising into warrior two. Bending into that left knee, good. Reaching out through both sets of fingertips. Flipping that left palm, revolve, reach back. Windmill forwards to our side angle. Beautiful, getting into it, coming right out of it. Bending into that right knee. Straightening through that left leg and then lunging forwards to our runner's lunge. Lowering that right knee, uncurling the toes. Press the right hand down into the mat. Left hand comes to left thigh. Opening the hip, reaching the knee out to the side, rolling onto that outer left foot. There we go. Opening your chest off to the left side. So for me, this mirror walk. Once again, if you'd like, bringing movement, working into that hip joint, stretching through that right hip flexor, or finding that spot where it feels best, and breathing there. Left knee moves back in towards the midline, both hands framing the foot, curling the left toes, right toes under, straightening through that right leg, hands ground, step it back, high plank. Hips lift, downward facing dog. Three more breaths here in our down dog. Four, two. Four, one. Easing forwards again, if you like, options, walk, step, or float. Up between your hands, inhaling, half lift. Exhale as you fold. Inhale, rising all the way to standing arms, reach up. Exhale, drawing hands together at heart center, balancing sequence. Coming into it right away. Hands come onto hips, balancing on our left leg first for tree pose, vrikshasana, rooting down through that left foot. Right foot can come onto the ankle, the calf, or reaching it up into the inner thigh. Just avoiding that knee joint. Don't need any compression there. Once your feet are set, hands draw together at heart center. Options for your arms. If you're balanced and want to move further when you're ready, extending arms upwards, reaching towards the sky. Option to challenge your gaze, finding a focal point of drishti either on the floor. For more challenge, shifting it. Maybe to where the wall meets the ceiling, maybe a point above you. If you'd like even more of a challenge, arm variations. Arms can wave in the breeze. Arms can come to wrap around you, grabbing for opposite elbows. Or if it's in your practice, coming to reverse prayer, feeling that inward rotation, prayer hands behind your back. For two more breaths, wherever you are, feet, arms, gaze variation, last breath. With control, everyone releasing it down, right foot regrounds. Hands coming back onto the hips, resetting yourself here in the center. Taking a moment, closing your eyes. Noticing the difference between the sides. As we bring balance into our practice, we'll move to our second side, blinking eyes open, grounding through that right foot. Left foot comes onto the ankle, the calf, or up into the inner thigh. Moving to your level, your variation in the legs. Once legs are set, hands come to heart center, and moving to where you're going. Arms can extend, arms can wave in the breeze, gaze can shift. Hands can come behind you or to prayer pose. Challenging yourself, knowing what you need, where you need work, where you need to let go. Allowing your breath to guide you there. Last breath here in this tree pose. Slow and controlled, releasing it down, coming back together in the center. Inhale, arms reach up, moving to our dancer pose. Right hand lowers down by the side, left arm continues to reach up. Right thumb faces the back of the room, catching for that right foot. So bend in that right knee, grabbing hold of the inner right foot. First beginning to just kick. So kick that right hand into the right foot. Keep kicking, kick, kick, kick. When you can't kick anymore, beginning to hinge at the hip. Left bicep stays by the right ear as you open through the chest. So a lot of building to get to this pose in our practice here today. Opening through the chest. Opening through that right quad and hip flexor. One more breath, balancing strong. And inhale, rising back through center, releasing both arms down, both foot down, right foot down. Inhale, arms reach up. Next side, left hand comes down by the side, thumb reaches towards the back, bend in that left knee, kicking, grabbing hold of that inner left foot. Right away, kicking into that left hand, strong through that left glute and left hamstring. Opening through the left side of the body. When you can't kick anymore, begin to hinge. Fullest expression of your dancer pose today for two. For one. And inhale, rising back through center, controlled, releasing it down. Beautiful, making our way down to our mat. Inhale, arms reach up. Exhale, forward fold, diving over both legs. Inhale and half lift. Exhale, hands plant, stepping back, high plank. Moving right into our downward facing dog as you exhale for three. For two. For one. Walking your feet all the way through your hands, lowering down to sit bones. Taking your time to get there. Coming into Baddha Konasana here. So butterfly, maybe some of you know it, about angle pose. Bringing your feet together to touch. Knees coming out wide. Yes, then grabbing hold of your feet. Opening your feet like a book. So reaching the outer foot bones together, opening the arches of the feet with your thumbs. As you continue to reach your knees out to the side, sit up a little bit taller, grounding through sit bones. Then beginning to hinge at the hips, working to maintain a flat and long spine. So flat back, long spine for as long as possible. Option to remain right here. Or if you'd like to begin to fold, round out the spine, just working to remain with that long spine for as long as possible before rounding out. Taking your variation of this bound angle pose as you fold.
Giving some time if you're moving towards
going, straightening your legs up towards the sky, letting your arms relax down by your sides. Eyes can come to a close here. And allowing your legs to actually relax. So slight bend in the knees, not pointing or flexing the feet, just letting them hang here. So not an active pose necessarily. More so just allowing yourself to be here, fully present, bringing your awareness into your feet first. As you notice the sensation. Feeling that move through your toes, through your feet, the bottoms of your legs, around your knee joint, to the tops of your legs and your hip crease. Where can you relax and let go even more here? Asking ourselves, is this particular moment okay? Fully supported by the earth here. Fully present in your body, your mind, your spirit. In connection and communion with one another.